It's one of the most idyllic places on the planet. It is the jewel in the New Zealand tourism crown. We're up north in the Bay of Islands for round one of the State New Zealand Ocean Swim Series. More than 800 competitors competing today in round one of the State New Zealand Ocean Swim Series. Conditions are idyllic. Let's catch up with Nick Jordan.
Conditions nearly perfect for open water swimming in Pai here today. A gentle outgoing tide with a wind forecast of 20 knots northerly, which is a tailwind for the competitors on the 3.3-kilometre journey from Russell to Pai here. These calm conditions should suit George O'Brien, the Australian who finished second in the series last year, and New Zealand's leading female swimmer Lauren Boyle competing in the State Ocean Swim Series. A forecast high of 24 degrees and sunshine, perfect conditions in Pai here.
Yeah, thanks, Nick. Everybody seemed pretty happy with the conditions. Let's catch up with some of our competitors.
Is your first time competing in the Pai here race?
It's actually my second, yeah. So first time was around about 2011. So, yeah, come back to do it again.
What do you like about the racing?
Just an accomplishment. Not out for, like, breaking records, just having a good time and, yeah, covering the distance. So it's good.
I'm looking forward to it. It's my first swim in the ocean. I've been training for a month and I can't wait.
And after this, will you do any more in the series?
We're doing all six, yeah.
And what are you hoping to do today?
Finish.
And beat me. He thinks he can beat me, but hey, we're in different age categories, so you know, we're not competing against each other, right? We're just having some fun.
Well, 79 test for the All Blacks, one of the most competitive people I know. That should be a great showdown. Nick Jordan caught up with a number of our elites.
George, tell us about the competition today. Who do you think will be your main rival?
Yeah, it's always tough here. There's a lot of good Kiwis here, and I've actually come over with a bunch of good Australians. We've got Yasu, who's from actually Japan, that I train with. He's very fast. Michael, and then, of course, the Kiwis, Troy and Philip. I know them pretty well, and they're always tough to beat.
Some tough competition from the two Australians that have come over and the Japanese number one ranked open water swimmer.
Yeah, they're good competition, but open water, it's anyone's race on any day, so just going to give it all and leave it all out there.
And how are you going to approach the 3.3Ks? Do you start off hard or do you start off slower and come with a big finish at the end?
I'm just going to go hard from the start, see where I'm at and just go.
Michael Scheel, welcome to New Zealand. Back again for your fourth State Ocean Swim Series, but your first time in Pai here. What are you expecting today?
Yeah, that's right. It's my first time in beautiful Bay of Islands. It is my fourth season, I think, from memory. So very excited to be actually at the first race of the season. Normally I compete in the last three. So this is a little bit different, and I'm really happy to be here.
This is second time in New Zealand. So I went to Rotorua and the Taupo this year, January, because I swam for New Zealand Open Water Championship. Yeah, I feel New Zealand is a really good place, so beautiful ocean, lake, so people kind, everything is good.
Lauren Boyle, conditions in the Bay of Islands today, the tide and the wind, how do you think that's going to help you?
I think if I get any kind of tailwind, that'll be awesome. I'm always looking for a bit of help, but it looks quite flat and not too choppy, so that's really nice for me. I don't really like too much chop. Yeah, it should be a good day.
Charlotte Webby, the State Ocean Swim Series. What are you looking forward to today?
Just go out there and have a bit of fun, see what the first one brings. It was a bit choppy. It looks like it's coming down now, but I'm just getting out there, see the things I need to work on for the rest of the season.
Looking across the field, your main competitor, Lauren Boyle.
Yeah, definitely. She's a class act, so it's awesome to be even just able to swim in the same category as her. So I'll hope to be close to her in this race and then hopefully improve on them for the rest of them.
Sam Watts, welcome to Pai here for the State Ocean Swim Series. What are you looking forward to today?
Having a good swim, obviously. I'm glad the conditions have cleared up a little bit, so hopefully it's going to be a good day.
Do you know the water? Do you know what to expect out there?
Not really. This is the first time I've been to New Zealand, so not sure. I'll get in, go for a little bit of a warm-up in a minute, and that'll be the first time I get to see what it's like.
And one name in particular, Lauren Boyle, Commonwealth Games gold medalist. What do you think it'll be like racing against her?
Yeah, it'll be a good experience. Hopefully just try and keep up for as long as I can.
Great rivalry in the women's. Lauren Boyle, Charlotte Webby, Samantha Watts out of Australia. Let's have a look at today's course for more than 700 competitors. A total distance of 3.3 kilometres. Starting in the original capital of Russell, seven marker buoys they need to navigate their way across before finishing at Paihia Beach. And we're not too far away from a start in one of the great ocean classics. The age group athletes, the elites, waiting for their final instructions. And look here at the great Lauren Boyle in the green cap. Charlotte Webby there in the pink cap. The very impressive Troy Velvet out of Australia. And then it is Samantha Watts. George O'Brien, the number one seed in the green cap, in the elite men. And then it is the Japanese competitor, Yasu Hirai, who has competed here previously. Next to him, New Zealand's big hope in Philip Ryan. So a beach start, the traditional start. This is where the surf skills become imperative. And we are underway. This will be fast. This will be furious. They've got to navigate their way through a fleet of boats anchored here in Russell. Joining me in commentary, former New Zealand swimming representative Scott Rice.
Yeah, thanks, Mark. Yeah, a few extra obstacles leading out of Russell in this swim. And a truly international field, another one you missed there, Michael Scheel, an accomplished Australian swimmer right there in the red number five. But looks at the moment that George O'Brien's taken a good body length lead over the rest of the field at the moment. So a good start there.
Yeah, a lot of swimmers do like to just try and get some clear water. They want to dictate the pace, and we've seen this from George O'Brien there, closest to the boat in the green cap. But immediately we just start to see it stretch out a little bit, and any time you see these swimmers in one long line, you know the pace is on. And the first look at our lead female competitors, and just what we thought, Charlotte Webby there in the pink cap, the narrowest of leads over Lauren Boyle, the Commonwealth Games 400 metre gold medalist, the short course world record holder over the 1500 metres.
Well, back to the men's field, Troy Belvert leading, he's lost his orange cap behind him, Yasu Hirai from Japan. George O'Brien in the gold cap, he's lost his green one. It's all changing. So George O'Brien in fourth place at the moment, and Philip Ryan hanging in third.
Like Philip Ryan, his signature really is just swimming with a sleeveless wetsuit. And this is the big challenge for these competitors. Really do come from a pool background. A lot of the open swim meets around the world at the Olympic Games level are non-wetsuit swims. And this does change the dynamics. You just feel here, Scott, the pace just being put on again by Troy Velvet, looking to try and stretch them.
Well, everyone's got their own tactics, don't they? Some start out strong, some like to deliver it at the end as well. So Philip Ryan, always consistent, as you say, the sleeveless wetsuit gives him a little bit more flexibility around the shoulders, but just swimming nicely with Yasu from Japan.
Oh, it's great to see, too, the lifeguards out there on the water. And the Japanese competitor, the one thing they do is they are patient. They are tough, though. That is just the nature of Japanese athletes, whether they be in the sport of athletics or in the sport of swimming.
And Troy Belvert from Cambridge, New Zealand, still pretty young at 22 for an open water swimmer and distance swimmer. And won the Nationals last year in the 800 metres freestyle, doing a great job in the World Cup circuit too. So just a body length lead over the Japanese athlete Yasu Hirai. And they've passed recently the number two orange can, meaning they're about 1,000 metres into this swim.
Well, interesting at the front of the women's field, because this is probably not what we expected so early, but Charlotte Webby in the pink cap here, the girl out of New Plymouth, 26 years of age, third ranked open water swimmer in New Zealand this year. She's got a considerable lead now on Lauren Boyle. So already pressure goes on the great Lauren Boyle, and she's out there now swimming by herself. She's got not even any of the sort of ranked men around her. It's going to be a lonely journey.
Well, the tides and the movement of the water in this channel are very unpredictable, so could possibly be pushing swimmers in different directions either side. But, Lauren Boyle's going to have to raise that head every now and then just to check if she's going all to her stroke.
Well, great race developing at the front of the men's race. Let's just go back through the field, currently sitting here in third place in the women's race in the silver cap out of Australia. This is the very impressive Samantha Watt. And again, flowing over here, courtesy of Jetstar.
Yeah, they've done a great job supporting elite swimmers both in Australia and New Zealand, Jetstar. But back to the men's field now. Troy Belvert still doing a wonderful job at the front of the field. He's pulling these elite men through. And we now start to see number five, Michael Scheel, just tagging on the end there out of Brisbane, Australia. He's been in the open water scene for many, many years and still very much a competitive force.
So the fundamental differences between open water swimming and pool swimming, no black line to follow. And you also have a thing called hydrodynamics. If you can sit on the feet of another swimmer, you will get dragged along. If you can get alongside and sit on the hip of another swimmer, you're going to save yourself some energy. But the other key thing, Scott, of course, is navigation. Lifting your head every 3 to 4 strokes. And when you do that, you've got to make sure your kick comes into play because you'll drop the hips and that creates drag. So many things for these swimmers to think about.
That's right, and it is so important to get that technique right with lifting the head. You've got to get your head up to look. Bad navigation can end someone's race, so it is important as they approach the state marker, the third marker on the course.
Well, Scott, first real significant move now coming from George O'Brien, the pre-race favourite, starting to put the squeeze on the rest of this field in the gold cap. Can the rest of the field answer the question? We are halfway through race one of the State New Zealand Ocean Swim Series, the Bay of Islands Classic. We are back in the beautiful Bay of Islands for race one of the State Ocean Swim Series. Now, earlier in the day, a number of youngsters took part in the State Ocean Kids race, aiming for a place in the Jetstar Super Swim Squad. Here's Hannah Milne, who is going for her third shot at the squad.
I really want to win the 200 because I really, really want to get into the swim squad again because it was so cool last time. You get to train with Olympians like Lauren Boyle and Rick Wells and Moss Burmester and those guys, and they help you with your technique, and you get to meet lots of other kids, and yeah, it's really cool. When I'm swimming, it makes me feel really happy because I get a lot of support from my parents and grandparents and things. I'm good at it, and I know I'm good at it, so it makes me feel good to be that good at something that I can win things, like, yeah. I really wanted to do it, so I got in, and yeah. I'm just pleased I made it, so.
Yeah, well done to all the youngsters. Now just having a look at where our race leaders are. They are halfway through this 3.3-kilometre journey, and it is still George O'Brien with just the narrowest of lead over the Japanese number one open water swimmer in Yasu Hirai. And George O'Brien from the Gold Coast, 22 years of age. Now, he was second in the series last year, third ranked in Australia, which makes him one of the great open water swimmers.
A lot of these Australian swimmers building up for the Australian National Champs in early February, and they'll be looking to try and gain a spot on the World Championships team next year. As we look at the spread here, about a body length between these swimmers. And back to Charlotte Webby at the front. She has got a mountain of a lead, Mark.
Oh, tough, isn't she? She's just incredibly tough, and she's supported the series for so long now. Very good at putting a lot back into the sport. And this is really her strength because when you think about it, the class of Lauren Boyle really out of shot, out of mind at the moment. But she won't be looking back. And that is the thing, isn't it, Scott? No rear vision mirror for any of these swimmers. What is going through the head of young Lauren Boyle?
Well, hey, look, she could be up here for a bit of fun, a little bit of relaxation before her season really gets underway. But look at this, the amount her head is up, it's all a bit different. And certainly, differs a huge amount from her pool swimming.
Well, Charlotte Webby in control. The men's race, though, starting to look more like a men's 1500-metre final. And this is Philip Ryan of New Zealand out to the right in the silver cap, sleeveless wetsuit, saying, OK, Japan, OK, the rest of Australia, I'm going to look to try and take this one out. So nothing ventured, nothing gained. What can we see now from George O'Brien in the gold cap? Hirai of Japan looking to try and jump across and get onto the feet of Philip Ryan. Wonderful stuff.
This guy needs a life membership to open water swimming. What a gutsy performance here by Philip Ryan. He's been in it for about 15 years, Philip. Back when I was swimming, that's how long it's been. But George O'Brien putting in a big challenge too.
Yeah, well, George O'Brien now realising that the breaks down the right-hand side is looking to come across, not dissimilar to what you see in America's Cup racing, looking to try and cover. So at the moment, we've got George O'Brien, a narrow lead over the Japanese competitor, Yasu Hirai. Philip Ryan currently sitting back in third place.
Well, I was speaking to George O'Brien before the race. He said he's a big, solid guy. He knows that, and he can put the sprint in at the end. And that's so important in open water and long-distance races that you do have a bit of sprint at the end. A little bit of backstroke here, just assessing where the rest of the field is. and almost letting Yasu just head on past, maybe to take a little bit of the drag and slip in behind.
Yeah, or try and get alongside of him, try and get on his hip there, and maybe just loosen up the shoulders a little bit too. These wetsuits can restrict these elite athletes. So look at this, just stroke for stroke at the moment. Nobody giving an inch, and Philip Ryan, the guts, just trying to see if he can stay on the feet there, trying to just stay in that slipstream and see if he can just benefit from the power of these two very good swimmers up front.
So Troy Belvitt still holding on there, and Michael Scheel just a body length or two behind. But wow, what a race. The number of changes of the lead, it's absolutely incredible. And, you know, they're getting closer to Pai here now. They're starting to really assess when are they going to go.
Well, talking of changes in the lead, it is another New Zealander now, Troy Belvitt, the 2013 New Zealand 800-metre champion.
This is amazing. This is fantastic. The Japanese Yasu Hirai, he's right there. He's holding on. He's been pretty consistent throughout this race. But this could be one of the biggest wins of this young boy's career if he can hold on here.
Well, you start to see the stroke, though, really begin to increase here. Unlike in the pool, it's not nearly as fluent. The kick starts to come into play. Now they're just looking to try and squeeze Troy Belvitt. He's got the Japanese competitor in the pink cap out to his right. He's got the very impressive George O'Brien just hanging off on his left-hand side. Fascinating battle beginning to unfold. They'll know they're not too far away. It's been sort of probably more mental. Now it becomes physical. Concentration, so important.
The arm turnover of Philip Ryan there just starting to wind up now. And as typically happens at the end of the race, is a bit of a spread now. George O'Brien on the left, Yasu Hirai, and looks like Troy Belvitt on the right, Mark.
Yeah, so this will be interesting. Who's got their line correct as they come up to the second to last of the big marker boys before they will have to make their way up to the finish line, which requires getting to their feet and a tough little run on the sand. So it is Japan versus Australia. New Zealand looking to try and hang in there and at least get themselves on the podium in the likes of Philip Ryan. But here we now start to see George O'Brien. What has he got left? He knows this Japanese competitor incredibly well. They train together. They've raced plenty of times in the past.
Starting to converge on each other. O'Brien breathing to the right. Yasu Hirai breathing to the left. They can see each other. Troy Belvitt 4 or 5 metres behind. Philip Ryan trying to hold on and try and snatch a third place as well.
Well, Michael Scheel in the red cap looking to try and just close the gap and see if he can get himself on the podium. Scheel, one of the top performing Australian swimmers out of Brisbane. Look at this. Japan versus Australia, toe-to-toe.
Beautiful stroke there by George O'Brien. Slightly different stroke with Hirai. He's got a very strong right arm and really lunging forward.
Well, I just wonder whether possibly the advantage sits with the Japanese competitor at the moment, because we didn't see him go out as quickly at the start. Good battle developing for third place here. But it is still O'Brien, though. He just won't give up. But you just sense, look at the Japanese competitor, Hirai, just getting himself a little bit higher out of the water. You just sense possibly he's just got that little bit more left in the tank. And now, the smallest of margins, advantage goes to the Japanese.
Well, it looks like he's just put the gas on just a little bit more. Has he got it over George O'Brien? O'Brien, such an accomplished open water swimmer, been in it for so long too. He will be experienced at these final stages of these open water races.
Well, they're about to converge, but you still sense that Hirai of Japan, half a body length at the moment, almost a full body length. He's just beginning to get his second win. You sense now he's in the zone. The first significant break coming from the Japanese competitor. And you'd have to say, George O'Brien in a world of hurt at the moment. Oh, this is just wonderful open water swimming. The crowd about to welcome these two great champions. But now Hirai of Japan has simply just cleaned this field out over the last 200 to 300 metres. What a swim. What a great day. What a way to kick off round one of the State New Zealand Ocean Swim Series.
The turbo boosters are on. Yasu Hirai, 15th at the Olympic Games in 2012. A standout performer in Japan in open water swimming, makes his way onto the beach to the welcome of the Pai here crowd.
Oh, a beautiful thing. And the thing with the Japanese, Scott, they just love it, don't they? They're such friendly people. They enjoy the adulation. But just how tough is that last bit too? Look at the ugly face, and I mean that for the fact they are just looking to try and get any oxygen in any way they can.
Oh, he looks absolutely shattered. Just shows you how much effort he's put in. George O'Brien kind of waving the flag and saying, yep, good on you. That was one hell of a race.
Well, that's all you can do now. Shake his hand and say, look, you were just simply better than me today. But congratulations too. What a class act Philip Ryan is. New Zealand getting himself on the podium.
He always seems to sneak onto the podium, old Philip Ryan. He's done a great job. Michael Scheel takes out fourth. And Troy Belvert, after that initial burst at the beginning, probably be a little bit disappointed about not holding on to a podium finish.
But he'll gain the experience too. A lot of these guys haven't done a lot of swimming in open water in a wetsuit. And this really is just an opportunity to learn, bank it.
And now we wait for the first of our ladies through the line, and looks like, yep, it is Charlotte Webby. She has held on to that big lead she had early in the race. A great effort by her, a win in the first event of the series. That does her well. And in second place, what a legend, Lauren Boyle, and what a year she's had. And in third place in the silver cap, the Australian Samantha Watts. We now hear from the winner, Yasuhiro.
Yasu Hiro, 43.59 in the State Ocean Swim Classic. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. So I'm very happy. Yeah, you know. Yeah. So this is my first trial, and this is the first Japanese man won. Yeah, I'm very happy.
It was a lot of fun. It was action-packed, mate. We were chopping and changing the lead all the time, so... if I have to come second, I'm happy that I came second to Yasu, yeah.
You got off to a flying start and put pretty clear water between you and Lauren Boyle early on. Was that the plan?
Yeah, she got me in the start, so I just pulled up beside her, and then eventually I just went past her, and then I didn't want to look back because I was just waiting for her to sit on my feet and maybe outsprint me in the last 200, so I just went for it, really.
Yeah, I think I started the race slightly ahead of Charlotte, and I was going quite fast at the beginning, and then she kind of went past me a bit, and I didn't really, I don't know, try that hard to catch her.
Oh, what a year she's had. Great to have her on the start line, but it's Charlotte Webby who wins in a time of 46 minutes and 55 seconds, almost 3 minutes clear of Lauren Boyle and then Samantha Watts out of Australia.
And in the men's field, a clear win by Yasu Hirai in 43.59, 15 seconds back to George O'Brien and Philip Ryan rounding out the top three.
And just confirming the overall series standings after one race, Charlotte Webby picking up the maximum 100 points.
And Yasu Hirai taking out 100 points in the men's race, remembering the best three of six races wins the series, $20,000 up for grabs.
And if you're inspired by what you've seen today, you want to get involved, there are still five races left in the series, the next being December the 7th, the Harbour Crossing, the great race. We look forward to having your company.